Well, here we go. Now let's go back in time to let's go back to the early 70s. Now I am a big fan of the 70s. Most people would probably think, because Daryl and I were so popular in the 80s, that was probably my favorite time, but it was not. I love the 70s for a lot of reasons. One reason is that everything was new. Every experience was new, every city we went to, the people we met, the success was new, the failures were new. And really, I think, to me, life is much more interesting when it's the story of how something happened in the process of becoming than kind of gloating on the victory lap, so to speak. Anyway, that's my crackpot philosophy on that. But anyway, this is a song from the Abandoned Luncheonette album, and it's one of my favorite albums that I've ever done. Maybe my favorite. And believe it or not, in October of this coming year, or this year, the Abandoned Luncheonette album will celebrate its 50th anniversary.
Wow.
So if someone would have told me back in 72, when we were about to make this record, that I would be singing this song 50 years later, I never would have believed it. 20-somethings never would have believed anything would happen 50 years later. But anyway, here we are, and yes. So this is the last song I ever wrote in Philadelphia before moving to New York City. And it's just a kind of pleasant love song, but it was inspired in a very strange way. I was standing on a street corner in Philadelphia, and a city bus pulled up. Windows were all kind of foggy. And this gal was in the window, and when the bus stopped directly in front of me, her face and my face were this far apart, and we looked at each other, and we locked eyes, and the bus pulled away. And as I walked across the street, I thought to myself, wow, I wonder what would have happened if we got together, you know? Got married, had some kids, got divorced, who knows? Yeah. 4 years old, love, I couldn't wait to get to sleep and dream about the one you wish was there beside you. In the past few days, I've grown love, it was on the phone. So nicely, and from the first time